What's up, guys? Rhen here with another Pixel Starships guide. How should you lay out your ship? And how do you use these armor blocks that the game gives you but doesn't tell you how to use? Today, we're going to answer all your questions, so let's get into it. Alright guys, so now we're going to talk about armor. This is those little square block thingies that the game gives you, and they say it's a good idea to use, but they never really tell you what exactly it is or how it works. So we're going to do that right now. So armor is something that protects specific rooms based on which rooms it's touching. So it doesn't protect all of your ship. You can't just put it floating in your ship and have it protect your hull. It has to be touching a room, and it only protects the rooms that it's touching. Now, in a little bit, we're going to give some specific examples of what those configurations look like, but just know that for now, whatever it's touching is what it's protecting. How much armor does it give? Well, that depends on your ship level and the level of armor block that you have, but you can see it goes up over time. For example, if you're ship level 6 and you've fully upgraded your armor as much as you can get 8 armor value per block. As you get all the way up to ship level 12, eventually you can get up to 17 armor value from a single block. So what does an armor value of 8 actually mean? Well, check out this chart. This shows how much damage reduction you get on a room based on what level of armor value is touching your room. So it's important to notice two things. The first one is that armor value doesn't exactly correspond to a percentage reduction. So for example, 100 armor doesn't mean you get 100% damage reduction and you don't take any damage. It's not quite linear. You can see the more armor you have, it starts to trail off and you get less and less benefit from each additional block of armor that you put. Now, that being said, more is always better, and so we're going to try to maximize it where we can. All right, so what would 2 blocks of armor with 8 value each look like? So 16 armor, you can go across the bottom of this table here and you can see when you get to 16, go up to the orange line, that's going to show us about a 14% reduction of damage. So what that means is if your room has 14% damage reduction, if it gets shot by a mining laser that deals 1 damage, it won't take the whole 1 damage, it'll only take 0.86 damage, aka 1 minus 14%. If your room is already dead, that means your hull will only take 0.86 damage instead of taking a full 1 damage. If you have 4 blocks, same idea applies. Now you've got 32 armor value at level 6, which means you're getting about a 25% damage reduction, or stated differently, you're only taking about 3/4 of the damage that your enemy is attacking you with. 6 blocks is about a little over 30% damage reduction. So you can see it's not quite a big a jump going from 2 to 4 and from 4 to 6. Each time you add on more armor, there's slightly less additional benefit, but it still always gets better with more armor. So we're going to try to maximize armor. So we talked about how many blocks of armor are touching a room, what does it mean to touch a room, and what are the rules in terms of when it applies to a room and when it doesn't. So we're going to go through some examples. The first easiest one is, what if your armor blocks are above your room? That works. What if they are below the room? That works. They can be to the side. That works. They can be below, like you see here. So I'm going to say this will work, but it's also not a good idea to do this, because the places where that armor is would also be the places that your crew walks to get into this room. So if you have your armor like this, it's going to protect the room, but if your room gets shot, your crew has no way to get in there to repair it. So in general, it's not a good idea to do this. Okay, so the next way that you'll see people using armor is like this. You see it's sort of diagonally adjacent to the room. The corners are touching, the side isn't touching. So this does not work. That does not count to the armor value of the room. So just keep that in mind. It has to be above or to the side or below or to the other side, but it can't be diagonal to provide value. So here's a quick recap. You can see the different configurations that work on the top. These ones on the bottom row, the left two don't work, and the one on the bottom right will work, but it's not a good idea because your crew can't get in there to repair your shield after it gets shot. All right, guys, so let's move on to layout. These are the general layout guidelines that are going to help you to think through when you're putting a ship together. So we talked about which rooms we want to have in terms of combat rooms and non-combat rooms. If you follow these 3 simple rules, you'll usually have a pretty decent layout. Rule number 1, all of your combat rooms need to be connected and armored. So connected means that they're on the same level, connected to other rooms or to a corridor or to a lift, and that they're all places your crew can access to repair in case your ship gets shot at, which, let's be honest, it will. Guideline number 2, you have lifts connecting your levels, and there are 3 subpoints here. So it'll help with free movement, and we'll look at what that means in a minute, but basically you need to think about where your crew has to walk to get from one room on one level to the other crew on another level, and put your lifts in the places that will minimize how long it takes your crew to get from place to place. Part B, not too long. So you will soon find out that, especially at the beginning of the game, these lifts are super slow. If you have a really long lift, it will be debilitating to your ship and your crew will just get trapped on different levels, not able to get to the other level and repair, and then you'll basically just die. Guideline C is kind of related to B, which is your levels are aligned if possible. What this means is that if you have two levels on the opposite sides of lifts, if they're aligned with each other vertically, that means your crew can walk across without the lift moving. So if you have three crew that need to get across, they can all walk across one after the other without the lift having to move in between. That'll save you some time. All right, number three, your critical rooms have four armor blocks or more. So what does it mean to be a critical room? We've got three possibilities. One is it a low HP room? So things like the bolter with one HP, things like the anti-aircraft with two HP. These are low HP rooms. It's not going to take long for your opponent to blow them up, and after they get blown up, all that damage is going to go to your hull. So it's important that you protect these to keep yourself from losing really fast. B, commonly targeted rooms are critical rooms. So these would be things like your shield, your android rooms, not necessarily low health rooms, but things that you know are going to get shot a lot. It's a good idea to go ahead and armor those up. Just because you know that's what's going to happen. And then C is similar to B, but any room that is critical to your strategy. For example, if you're a ship that relies on the teleporter, you probably want to have lots of armor on that teleporter, not only because it's going to get shot a lot, maybe, but also because that room is critical to your survival and it's your strategy to how to win the battle. So there's a lot of other nuance and subtlety that you'll be thinking about later on in the game when you do layout design. But for now, if you follow these three simple guidelines, it will probably result in a ship layout that's at least pretty decent and will carry you along till you know more about the game. Okay, so guys, we're going to look at some layout examples, and I've actually gone and pulled some random ship layouts that people have posted on the Discords. So we don't know if these are good or bad. A lot of times people post layouts without having a lot of experience. That's actually perfect for this example because we're gonna see some of the common mistakes that people make and how you guys can avoid them when you're laying out your ships. All right, okay, let's take a look at this next pirate layout. Again, it's a pirate, it's gonna be two levels. They've also got this weird shield thing going on over here, so we can see right away that that's probably an issue. But let's go through our list. So number one, are all the combat rooms connected? Yes, they are. We can see that they are. They've got most of their non-combat rooms over here. Now we can see that there are some of these rooms that they could really take off the ship. For example, they could take off the bridge. Other than that, it looks pretty good. They've got the gym on here. That's not terrible. It's okay. So let's go to number two. Does it have lifts? It does have a lift over here connecting the two levels. The lift isn't too long, so that's good. But again, we run into the same issue, which is we have the lift all the way on one end over here. And nothing over here that's connecting us. So if a crew wants to get from this reactor to this laser, it's gonna have to run all the way here, down, then all the way back across. So not a very good position of the lift. I would move that lift to the middle just to help the crew move around. Okay, let's take a look at the armoring. The armoring is not bad. They've got this armor belt right down the middle. That's pretty common, especially on these pirate ships. Now, these pirate ships are pretty narrow, so you have a limited range of areas where you can have sort of a sandwich above and below. I like that they have this low HP room in between these two levels of armor to get the four blocks on it. Looks like they started to do the same thing down here with these bolters, but they haven't quite finished it. So what I would like to see is at least four armor on these bolters. They could fill in these squares right here. At least four armor on this android room. The shield just needs more armor. You could probably take the shield and move it over here to where this mining laser is, put some armor down here, that would give it six armor. This reactor over here and the shield over here, not quite sure why those are where they are. I would probably move them into these two rooms here. Also not sure why this crew is over here in this bedroom. Perhaps they're leveling them up, but just want to point out, if you have this crew over here starting here, those crew cannot get to the combat room, so they're not going to be able to help in the combat. Okay, now we're going to look at this Qatarian. Looks like a level six. Let's go through our checklist. So number one, are the combat rooms connected? Yes, it looks like they pretty much are. Number two, are there lifts? There's a lift right here. So you can see right away, this is a one, two, it's kind of a 2.5 split level lift. We've got two main combat levels here, it looks like, and three unarmored lift levels over here on the left, which you can tell is, you know, it's gonna be a problem for sure when it gets the armoring. So I would say this is kind of pushing the boundary on this lift, because you've got three levels you're trying to connect, two combat levels and three unarmored lift levels. So if there's a way we could kind of compact this down a little bit, I would be a little happier in terms of that lift. We see the same kind of issue we saw a minute ago, which is here's all of our combat rooms and our lift is all the way over here to this side, but they do have another lift over here on this side. So I'd say that's decent. It's pretty good. They could have put maybe one in the middle, but they've got two total, which is pretty good. And they don't really have another room to put another lift in to have three. So if you're gonna have two, I'd say this is a pretty decent way to do it. You could move this lift maybe a little over here to the right, but then you run into questions of how do you fit these reactors here with some armor. Speaking of armor, you can see that these three reactors have no armor. That's gonna be a potential problem. If there's one room you can get away with not armoring as well, it is the reactors, because it has such a high health. It will give your crew a chance to run there and repair it before you start taking hull damage. But there are some strategies later on that's going to blow up your reactor and then just shoot it to do a ton of hull damage really fast. So you do want to have some armor on your reactors. It doesn't have to be the 3 to 4 armor for the other rooms, but you need something. Aside from the reactors, we do have a pretty good armor built on all these. They do have 4 on this 2 HP photon. You can see that they have 4 on this bolter. It's a little bit of an inefficient layout because this one and this one are kind of wasted. They're only touching one room, but they do have 4 on this bolter. They've got 3 plus the beacons on this one, which I guess is okay. They've got 4 plus 3 beacons on the shield. I probably would have swapped out these beacons and maybe put 1 or 2 armors on the shield instead of the beacon. But, you know, it's always a game of trade-offs. So overall, this ship is looking a little better. Still a couple things I could improve, but not too bad overall. All right, the last one we're going to look at is another pirate design. This one looks like a level 7. So let's go through and see, are all our combat rooms connected? Yes, it looks like they are. Where's our lift? Lift is right here. We've got one lift. Now, it's one lift for a long ship. So that could create a little bit of congestion if everybody's trying to run through this one lift. But again, you know, these pirate ships are designed a little on the small side, so it's always a trade-off. And it looks like this particular design has a lot of the extra bedrooms in it, and so they are a little bit tight on space. It looks like they have removed their bridge, which is what we talked about doing, and they've removed their other non-combat rooms that we talked about not needing. So that's a good sign. Lifts looks like it's decent. It's right in the middle, so it gives easy access to both sides. The levels are not aligned, but again, that's a bit of a consequence of this pirate ship layout. And so, you know, you're never going to get quite the perfect thing that you want, but this is looks like a pretty decent compromise. Okay, let's look at the armoring. The critical rooms have 4 plus armor. So we've got low HP room here, that's got 4. Low HP room android here, that's got 4. This one has 4. So the low HP rooms, those look pretty good. Next is our commonly targeted rooms. Let's look at the shield. That's got 6 or 5 plus a beacon. That's pretty good. Teleport, it's got not quite 6, it's got 5. 5 is almost as good as 6, so I'm gonna say that's okay. So that's pretty good. Now how about the rest of the rooms? We've got 3 on this missile, 3 on this plasma, 3 on this missile, 3 here. This reactor has 2 plus a beacon. The reactors are maybe a little low. This reactor only has 1 beacon. This reactor down here on the right only has 1 armor. So again, a little weak on the reactors. It looks like they're using a teleport strategy here. So maybe they're not too concerned with the reactors getting shot. It just kind of depends on the strategy. Later on, they may choose to rearrange things to put their teleport in a more central location, but this looks just fine for level 7. So I'd say this is a pretty good compromise in terms of meeting our design criteria while still trying to fit all the stuff on their ship that they wanted to fit on the ship. All right, guys, so hopefully this gives you a good idea of what the common mistakes are for layout and armoring and how you can avoid them when setting up your ship. Start out with the right rooms. Remember that you need to armor those critical rooms. Use a good lift design, connect all your stuff, and you should be in pretty good shape. So hopefully this has been helpful. We are going to be releasing a series of these introductory type guides for new players and then slowly progressing to medium and advanced type strategies. So stay tuned for more. All right, guys, so if you've watched any of my Pixel Starships videos, you know how critical it is to join a good fleet and a good fleet alliance. So if you're looking for a home in Pixel Starships, the Trek Alliance is a top-tier alliance featured in the Trek Federation, which has been one of the top three fleets in the world for the past 3 years. This is a place where some of the top players in the game will help teach you about strategy and game mechanics, helping to improve your experience and help your ship get stronger. Whether you're brand new to the game or whether your division is superstar, the Trek Alliance has a fleet that's right for you. So if you want to make some new friends or get better at this game, come check out our public Discord at bit.ly/Trek Federation.